Alright, so we'll go through the landing checklist. Anti-ice, which just came up on a true air temperature of 10 degrees Celsius, I'll go ahead and flick those off. Quick spots, usually somewhat hard to get to, but I got them there. We'll go over to heading select mode so we can sort of self-vector ourselves for the approach into Atlanta. Currently doing 234 knots indicated, and Atlanta has a METAR, a ATIS, an altimeter, a barometric pressure of 292 inches of mercury, so we'll go ahead and make sure that's selected. 2992 is selected, and the backup. We'll go ahead and maintain 3,000 feet for the remainder of the approach. Nose coming up, we'll bleed off some airspeed, after which, at about 210 knots, I'll go ahead and drop the first degree of flaps. We'll stay at flaps 1 for some time, and then we'll go directly to flaps 5 afterwards. There comes the airspeed at 215 knots, 214. I'll go ahead and call for flaps 1. And the seatbelt sign also comes on once the first degree of flaps has been selected. Make sure that all the lights are on. The landing lights are on. Back to the light, and we have our the airport behind us. So I'll go ahead and update the traffic at Atlanta with our intentions. So we're currently on the downwind leg. We're holding here at 3,000. We're gonna make our left-hand turn. It's gonna be a series of two left-hand turns to get on the base, but we'll hit the final, and we're gonna call that in a second. So I'm on Unicom. That's 122 decimal 8. Set our minimum descent altitude of 470. Let's go ahead and enter base here for 26 right. This is gonna begin our first left-hand turn here. lovely night lighting here, provided by X-Plane, maintaining 3,000 feet. Go ahead and bring us down to 205 knots. We'll go to flaps 5. Something interesting I've learned about the 737 over the time that I've been flying it is that, especially in the newer variants of the 737, the flap 2 setting is almost absolutely in daily usage. It's barely ever used, so we usually just skip it and go right to flap 5. Go ahead and reduce airspeed one more time. It's at 185 in the box. At this time, I like to go ahead and get our approach speed. That's 141. And I just go ahead and drag it here for visual reference. Maintaining 3,000 feet. That zoomed in a bit. I'll go ahead and call up the flaps 10. Disengage the autopilot. We'll maintain 3,000 feet. Now begin the left-hand turn, the final left-hand turn onto the final. 426 right. We'll maintain 3,000. We're well below our actual schedule ascent. At Bamboo we would be at 4,000 feet, but I'll just play it on the safe side here and select 3,000. Let's maintain that. Alright, so we do have the runway in sight. I did not have to calculate the adjusted VREF. As you can see, we're pretty much gear down. We're pretty much having a perpendicular crosswind, a crosswind perpendicular to the direction of light. Go ahead and disarm the auto follow. that's 30. The cockpit vibrates as a result of increased aerodynamic drag from the flaps. Alright, now I have a good indication of my altitude and where I need to be based off of the poppy. Just want to keep monitoring that. Speed. Minimums landing.
Minimum.
Again. I forgot to set their minimum descent altitude. Manual braking. Trying to pull left here. Great flight. We'll stop the clock. We will also go ahead and put the lights back on. It's for situational awareness. Not too bright. The landing lights off, the runway turn on, turn off lights off. Taxi lights on. Okay, let's go ahead and turn off the strobe lights. Start switches to off. And TCAS mode selected to standby. Let's take a left here. So pulling up from the taxiway. Sorry for the cut in the video there, my roommate. Back. Alright, let's go ahead and begin the turn in here. Just to switch the source of alternating current, so we're on AP gens now. For the generator, sorry. Right here.